Hi everyone, my name is Holly Hess and I am one of the program development interns here at the Enright Center. In today's health lecture, we're going to be discussing why you should keep dancing. I have been dancing since I could remember, probably since I was about 4 years old, and I still enjoy it today. It's my favorite way to exercise. I guess you could say I'm pretty good since I have 3 national championships under my belt from high school, which means that I know what I'm talking about, and I can confirm that dancing is so good for you. So today we're going to be going over why dancing is good for you and the potential health and mental benefits it can have. Then we're going to go over the different styles of dance and hopefully find one that seems fun for you. Lastly, I'm going to demonstrate a quick 4-minute dance workout that you could kind of put into your daily life if you want to try some dance moves out. I've done it to a very fun song, so I hope it'll be really fun. And then that's all I have for you. So first, we're going to talk about the health benefits. So there are so many possible benefits to receive from dancing. First off, it can improve your mental health. Dancing has been argued to reduce mental health disorders such as depression. A group of Australian researchers, they completed a study on dancing and mental health, and it found that men and women with mood disorders who participated in the 2-week tango dancing class, they felt less depressed after it, and dancing reduced their anxiety and their stress levels, and they experienced less anxiety and insomnia. So that is about the mental health. So next, it can stimulate your mind and memory. Not everyone thinks of dance as related to memory care, but honestly, it has improved my memory so much. Memorizing steps and a dance routine makes for a great mental exercise. A study in the New England Journal of Medicine found that dancing can reduce the onset of dementia, making dance a suitable activity for people with memory issues. In fact, even those who struggle with memory loss may develop muscle memory whereby their body remembers movements and music in a remarkable way. I can still remember dance routines from 5 years ago that I did in high school because of muscle memory and the repeating of doing it. Once you keep doing it, you will remember it. Your body will retain it. So dancing can also increase independence in social life. It provides the opportunity to participate in something you're interested in, giving the chance to get out of the house after this long year of COVID. When you join and meet other people, you may start to discover other types of dancing and you may want to try it out. One of the great things about joining senior dance classes is you're going to find people like-minded your own age at these classes because they're for seniors. You may find a dance partner or a group of people you feel comfortable dancing with. Even in times of social distancing, dancing as a part of a class or with a friend over a video chat can be a fun way to spend time together. You will start to form friendships and this will help you maintain a good social life. If anyone is interested in taking a dance class at the Enright Center, let us know because me and the other program development intern, we've been talking about starting a dance class and it would kind of have some cardio, some kickboxing, definitely be an upbeat class, but we wanted to gauge some interest first. So if you are interested, respond to us, let us know because we are thinking about it and we want to start one. So that's my little spiel on that. And so next we're going to talk about how dance can improve your balance and coordination. Senior dance classes and dancing in general offer elderly people physical benefits, which include improvement in balance, strength and gait, and it will help you reduce your falls. A study found that a 37% reduction in fall risk for those aged 65 and older when reviewing clinical trials on dance-based mind motor activities. So they were doing a trial from around the world. This review found an association between dancing and mobility, balance, and lower body strength. Dance intensely works on your leg muscles and as well as improves your coordination. You can move all the joints in your body in dance routines and group and partner dancing. So dance is just a great way to get that all over body workout. If you don't know exactly what you want to work on, do some dance moves because you'll be working your arms with the motions. You'll be doing your legs. You'll be using every muscle that you have. So the constant moving that dancing requires can help enhance your bone health. And the decline is which another risk of aging. We know that your bone health declines as you go on. With constant stimulation, the bone cells continually turn over, which means less frailty and fewer broken bones. Elderly people who live a sedentary life, or even those who only utilize the effects of walking or minor exercises, will experience more bone loss and frailty than those who participate in something as vigorous and stimulating as dancing. A study followed a group of elderly people who took a dance class for mere 1 hour a week. All that was, 1 hour a week. This is all it took for them to experience the better posture, quicker reaction times, and sharper minds that dancing confirms. So next, we're going to talk about the various dance styles that you could try. So I got a bunch listed, but my personal favorite is dance cardio aerobics, such as jazzercise or Zumba. Jazzercise is a pulse-pounding, beat-pumping, body-blasting fitness program. It's high intensity. It's a dance party. It fuses cardio, strength, Pilates, hip-hop, yoga, and kickboxing. Super fun, but also remember, you can do low-impact class and still get the best workout and have just as much fun. Zumba is similar, but it kind of has a Latin flair, and it combines Latin and international music with dance moves. Fast and slow rhythms to help improve your cardiovascular fitness. I like to take these type of classes 3 times a week. There's a bunch in Bloomington. If you would like me to let you know about those, just send me an email and we can talk about it. But another popular style for dancing for seniors is ballroom dancing. There are many different types of ballroom dancing that differ in speed, music, and steps. Latin ballroom dancing is very popular. You've probably seen the Latin styles such as the salsa, the tango, and the cha-cha being performed at some. If you've ever seen Dancing with the Stars, then you know what these are. You can perform these styles with a partner or by yourself. So those are some options. But if you're someone who likes a slower pace, kind of likes the elegance, you should try waltz or foxtrot. Both of these styles are performed to slower music with longer but slower movements. So the next style I want to talk about is line dancing. I feel like this style is often forgot about because it's not, as you know, as competition, but it's also very, very fun. I think it's so, it can be low impact or it can be high impact. So participants will line up in rows and execute the same movements in a synchronized manner. Everyone dances alone, side by side, facing the same direction in lines or rows. Each dance consists of a sequence of steps that's repeated throughout the music. You've probably seen country line dancing or square line dancing because these are the most popular. So I would definitely try those out if you're looking just for something fun to do, but you don't want to take it too serious. So for those of you that want to work on your coordination and balance, clog dancing and tap dancing is for you. Clogs are heavy wooden shoes that are worn for beating out rhythms and movements. So they're made in a special way to have certain different sounds that come out when they're tapped. So cloggers perform with an up and down body motion, and they tend to make the most sounds with their heels. The movements are typically more flat-footed than tap dancers, which are on the balls of their feet. So on the other hand, tap dancers stay light on their feet and tend to dance with the melodies of the music rather than to the beats. Tappers wear different shoes that have a metal tap on the bottom that create different noises. So just to reiterate, clogging and tap are kind of the same thing, mostly with footwork and movements, but clogging is a whole different shoe and focused on the heel when tap is on the ball of your foot, and they make different sounds. So for those of you guys that want to try dancing, but you're not sure if you're just in the right health or you're kind of nervous that you can't keep up, don't worry. You guys, there's some options for you. You could try a seated dancing class, which they do have those, or ballet for seniors. These classes are specifically modified to be done at all ages. So I'm gonna stop sharing my screen now, and I am going to start our workout. So I'm gonna put on the music, and I'm gonna show you guys this quick 4 minute routine that I came up with. I'm sure you're gonna know the song because it's a very popular song, but I'm gonna show you guys, I'm gonna walk through it, and if you guys wanna do this on your own, it's just the regular song you should be dancing, and I'm gonna get up now and I'm gonna start it. So here we go.
Thank you. job, everybody. Awesome work.
So that is all I have for you. And just a reminder, if you do this and you forget a step, march it out. Just keep moving. That's the whole point, is to get you moving. So again, my name is Holly. I'm out of breath from that. But if you guys have any questions or concerns about anything, reach out to me, the Enright Center email, or call us at our phone number, 812-272-4808. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video.